हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम पुरुषोत्तम विश्वकर्मा एंड टुडे आई एम बैक विद द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर डीप वाटर। टिल नाउ वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड फोर पार्ट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर वेयर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द अर्ली लाइफ ऑफ विलियम ऑरविले डगलस एंड हिज फियर ऑफ वाटर, हाउ ही फियर्ड वाटर। नाउ लेट सी द समरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर बाई विलियम ऑरविले डगलस। द स्टोरी हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम द ऑथर्स ऑटोबायोग्राफी। दिस स्टोरी डीप वाटर has been taken from the author's autobiography. It is an autobiographical part. And what is the name of the autobiography of William Orville Douglas? Of Men and Mountains. So this chapter is taken from Of Men and Mountains. This is an excerpt of Men and Mountains. In this piece, he tells about his fear of water. In this piece of writing, in this lesson, William Orville Douglas tells us about his fear of water and how he conquered it. In this piece, he tells about his fear of water and how he conquered it. By determination and will power, by his resolution, by his determination, he overcame his fear of water. This lesson is basically about the fear of William Orville Douglas and how he conquered his fear of water. As a child, when he was 3 or 4 years old, he would go to the beach in California. He accompanied his father to California beach. When he was only 3 or 4 years old, he would go to the beach in California. वो जाता था कहाँ पे? California beach पे with his father. He would accompany his father. He would get scared by the might of the huge waves. And this was the first time when he had an aversion to the water. और ये पहली बार ऐसा था जहां से उसका aversion शुरू होता है, a strong dislike शुरू होती है to the water. He would get scared by the might of the huge waves which swept over him, and it instilled a fear in his subconscious mind. And this instilled, this provoked, this created a fear in his subconscious mind that remained with him till he was resolute to overcome his fear. A few years later, after a few years, in his eagerness to learn swimming, he wanted to learn swimming when he was 10 or 11 years old. In his eager to learn to swimming, he joined a swimming pool. And what was the pool? YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association in Yakima. He joined the pool where an incident further increased his terror. A misadventure happened over there. What was the misadventure? He was thrown into the deep end. What was the deep end? How deep it was? 9 feet. The depth of deep end was 9 feet. He was thrown to the deep end by a bruiser boy. And how old the boy was? 18 years. The boy was of 18 years, having thick hair on his chest, a strong built personality, a specimen of good physique. He pushed into the pool by another boy. He was thrown into the pool by a boy and experienced death closely, where he had his encounter with death. He had experienced his death over there. Many years after that incident, after some years after that incident, उस घटना के बाद एक घटना घटती है जब वो 3-4 ईयर का था, फिर एवर्जन शुरू हो जाता है उसका वाटर से, फिर 10-11 साल का होता है, फिर जाता है YMCA पूल में, वहाँ भी उसके साथ एक मिस एडवेंचर होता है और फिर एवर्जन शुरू हो जाता है, लेकिन वो रुकता नहीं है, फिर से उसकी इच्छा जागती है दैट ही शुड लर्न स्विमिंग. Many years after that incident, he stayed away from water, but the desire to go fishing and swimming in nature was strong enough to motivate him to overcome his fear. Although he had aversion to water, he had a feeling, a strong dislike, but there was something in him. In a corner of his heart, there was a desire to go fishing and swimming in nature, and that was strong enough to motivate him, to provoke him to overcome his fear. उसने उसको प्रेरित किया कि चलो लड़ो, किससे? अपने फियर से, अपने डर से. And he did the same thing. Ultimately, he was the victor. He learned swimming with the help of an instructor who ensured that William knew swimming well enough to be able to swim in huge lakes and waterfalls. In 1 October, he hired an instructor who helped him to learn swimming. How? क्या करता था वो? इसकी कमर में एक बेल्ट लगाता था, उससे एक रस्सी बांध करके जो एक पुली से होके जाती थी, दूसरा एंड वो खुद पकड़ के रखता था और इसको पानी में लटका के रखता था, और कभी कभी रस्सी ढीली कर देता था तो ये नीचे बैठने लगता था और इसका डर फिर से ताज़ा हो जाता था. बट आफ्टर 3 मंथ्स ही वॉज एबल एनफ टू लर्न स्विमिंग, टू स्विम in huge lakes and waterfalls. He learned swimming after all. Still, when he would swim, the fear from his childhood experiences embedded in his subconscious mind would grip over and over again. फिर भी जैसे ही वो पानी में जाता, जब भी तैरने जाता, वो चाइल्डहुड एक्सपीरियंस, वो चाइल्डहुड फियर, दैट वॉज केप्ट इन हिज माइंड, इन हिज सब कॉन्शियस माइंड, स्टिल अलाइव, वुड ग्रिप हिम ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन. वो उसको जकड़ लेता ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन. ही वॉन्टेड टू कॉन्कर दैट फियर. ही हैड अ डिजायर, ही हैड अ रेजोल्यूशन टू कॉन्कर, टू ओवरकम दैट फियर. And what is that fear we are discussing about? Fear of water. He faced it sarcastically, thinking that now, as he knew how to swim, he faced it sarcastically. मजाक में लिया इसको उसने अब, thinking that, keeping in mind that now he knew how to swim. He knew very well how to swim. और आपको जब पता है कि आप तैर सकते हैं तो पानी से डरने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, आपको डर नहीं लगेगा कि आप जानते हैं कि आप पानी से आसानी से बाहर निकल जाएंगे। वट हार्म कुड इट डू टू हिम, ही न्यू वेरी वेल दिस वॉटर कैन नॉट हार्म हिम इन एनी वे, इट कुड नॉट हार्म हिम इन एनी वे, इन अ लीस्ट पॉसिबल वे। ही चैलेंज्ड हिज फियर इन द फेस ऑफ इट एंड फाइनली इट वुड वैनिश। ही यूज्ड टू से टू हिज फियर, मिस्टर टेरर I don't fear you. I am not afraid of you anymore. And just after that fear would vanish. वो fear भाग जाता। It was a baseless fear instilled in his subconscious mind. This was a baseless fear which was instilled in his subconscious mind. This experience was valuable for him. This feeling when he said to his fear that he was not afraid of that fear anymore, this experience was valuable for him. He had experienced terror and death. Till now he had experienced both terror and death. When he had experienced death, when he was into the YMCA pool, when he was thrown into the pool by that bruiser boy of 18 years age, he overcame it and finally conquered it. He overcame his fear and finally became triumphant. Victory was his. William realized that death is peaceful. William realized that death is peaceful, and it is the fear of death that is terrorizing. William को समझ में आ चुका था, William और विले डगलस को अब ये समझ में आ चुका था that death is peaceful. William को अब ये समझ में आ चुकी थी बात कि मौत शांति से भरी हुई है। मरने के बाद तो शांति ही शांति होती है, सारे कष्ट जीवित रहते ही होते हैं। सो ही हैड अंडरस्टूड, अल्टीमेटली ही अंडरस्टूड दैट डेथ इज पीसफुल एंड इट इज द फियर ऑफ डेथ दैट इज टेररिजिंग। हम किससे डरते हैं? मौत से डरते हैं। मौत का डर ही हमें डराता है। एज इट वॉज सेड बाई प्रेसिडेंट रूजवेल्ट, ऑल वी हैव टू फियर इज फियर इटसेल्फ। बस डर से ही हमें डर लगता है, और अगर डर ही हम ना रखें, डर को मार दें, तो फिर हमें कोई चिंता करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है। Will no longer be in such a situation to be afraid of anything. His will to live life grew intensely. Then after, his will power was strong enough that grew intensely in a large proportion as he had overcome his fear and started living fearlessly. He started living his life fearlessly, without any fear. Now he could go for swimming, for boating, for canoeing, at any place without any fear of water. Now he was able to enjoy his life at full length.